عليه. نعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، ونشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا وحبيبنا وشفيعنا ومتاعنا محمدا عبده ورسوله. أما بعد، فقد قال الله تعالى في القرآن المجيد والفرقان الحميد: أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إن الذين قالوا ربنا الله ثم استقاموا تتنزل عليهم الملائكة ألا تخافوا ولا تحزنوا وأبشروا بالجنة التي كنتم توعدون. نحن أولياؤكم في الحياة الدنيا وفي الآخرة، ولكم فيها ما تشتهي أنفسكم ولكم فيها ما تدعون، نزلا من غفور رحيم. صدق الله العظيم. قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم: ألا وإن الدنيا عرض حاضر يأكل منه البدو والفاجر، ألا وإن الآخرة أجل صادق يقضي فيها ملك عادل قادر، يحق الحق ويبطل الباطل، ألا وإن الخير كله بحذافيره في الجنة، ألا وإن الشر كله بحذافيره في النار، ألا فاعملوا وأنتم من الله على حذر، واعلموا أنكم معروضون على أعمالكم، فمن يعمل مثقال ذرة خيرا يره، ومن يعمل مثقال ذرة شرا يره. وكما قال صلى الله عليه وسلم. Respected ulama-i-kiram, elders, beloved brothers in Islam, in this age of zulmat and darkness, in this age which is reminiscent, reminds us of the prophecy of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, wherein he exhorted his ummah, badiru bil a'mal, and hasten towards a'mal, persevere upon a'mal. What is the underlying wisdom behind this exhortation? That never ever become complacent and satisfied with the level of your deen and iman. Badiru bil a'mal. Why? Fitanan, he said, fitnas are coming. Test, trials, tribulation. He described the onset of these fitnas, كَقِطَعٍ مِنَ اللَّيْلِ الْمُظْلِمِ. He said, like sections or portions of a dark night. Ulama explained this analogy. They say the transition which occurs daily from light to darkness is not an instant one. You cannot define the exact moment when light turns to darkness, but stealthily, secretively, darkness encroaches until eventually you realize it is completely dark. Like that, Rasulullah said, fitna secretly, stealthily will come upon my ummah. And what will be the effect of these fitnas? يُصْبِحُ الرَّجُلُ مُؤْمِنًا وَيُمْسِي كَافِرًا. He said, a person in the morning will have iman, by the evening he will have become a kafir. يُمْسِي مُؤْمِنًا وَيُصْبِحُ كَافِرًا. A person in the evening will have iman, by the next morning he will have become a kafir. يَبِيعُ دِينَهُ بِعَرَضٍ مِّنَ الدُّنْيَا. What will be the underlying cause that those who are born with miftahul jannah, those who were born with the key to jannah, those who were born with the key to eternal success and paradise, will give up that iman and will adopt kufr? What will be the underlying cause of that? Rasulullah said, يَبِيعُ دِينَهُ بِعَرَضٍ مِّنَ الدُّنْيَا. He said, my ummah will sell their deen. Iman will become a commodity which is sold in the marketplace. The value of iman, the value of iman, the value of this deen will have come out of the ummah. Such an age, such a period we are living in. A few years ago we met a Jamaat in South Africa in a town called Ladysmith. Jamaat was from Indonesia. Eight brothers in the Jamaat, seven of them over 60 years of age. They were out for 4 months in the path of Allah, couldn't speak English also. Only one brother could speak little English, he was under 60. So I asked him, bhai, give us some karguzari of your country. The most populous Muslim country in the world, Indonesia. He said the population is 280 million people. 13,000 islands. He said, Malisab, cautious estimate in the last 20 to 30 years, 10% of the population have become Murtad. That is 30 million people born with Iman. 30 million people who were born with the key to Jannah have become Murtad. He said 13,000 islands, some islands, 1 million residents, not one alim, not one madrasa, not one maktab to be. Our Jamaat in that same safar, we went to one town where there was a Darul Uloom. We met one of the mashayikh of the Darul Uloom. He says, Munisab, in the street in front of this Darul Uloom, in the last month, two families have become murtad. This Iman is not something that we can take for granted. This period that we are living in is an age of zulmat, is an age of darkness. In every direction, we hear karguzaris, we hear reports that Jamaat are traveling throughout the entire world. Places where Ulad al-Sahaba, people who are from the progeny of Sahaba, people in whose veins the blood of Sahaba were flowing, left their countries or left their backgrounds or left their localities and came into a different environment, and now, in fact, I remember a few years ago, whilst we were in Jamaat in Australia, I met this one brother who I recognized from my childhood. He used to be the person who used to open the masjid. In the 1960s, 70s, the masjid in our locality, every day, at the time of Tahajjud, it was his responsibility to open the door of the masjid. This person migrated for whatever purpose or object. I'd met him in Australia after many, many years, and I asked him, bhai, how's everything? How did you realize the objective, the purpose behind your migration? I can remember right till now, if I close my eyes, as if I can picture in my mind's eye the face of this person. Whether he's living now or not, Allah knows best. Allah finished cover his moon. Tears entered his eyes. He says, Molana, I made hijrat for the sake of deen, for the sake of dunya. From a worldly perspective, I realized I cannot complain. And then tears entered his eyes and he said, I do not know what answer I'm going to give in Allah's court. He says, three of my granddaughters are Murtad. Born with Iman, the person who used to open the masjid, there is no guarantee. There is no guarantee. There is no basis or grounds on which any one of us can claim that because we are reciters of Kalima La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah, hum to ab jannat ke thekedar ban gaya. The Jannat is our guarantee. Inna quluba bani adama bayna usba'ayn min asabi ar-Rahman yuqallibuhuma kayfa yasha. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, verily the hearts of Ibn Adam, the hearts of insan are between two fingers of the fingers of Rahman. Yuqallibuhuma kayfa yasha. Allah can turn those hearts in whatever direction He wants. This talab, this desire, the spark of love for Allah and His Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that is bringing about gatherings like this. This gathering on the nisbat of the love of Allah and His Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, especially in this day and age of zulmat and darkness, wallah, by the qasam of my Allah, this is not an ordinary thing. This is Allah's very great ni'mat, Allah's very great favor, Allah's very great bounty, and the shukr of this is wajib. The shukr of this is wajib, like the poet says, Meri talab bhi kisi ke karam ka sadqa hai. Meri talab bhi kisi ke karam ka sadqa hai. Ye kadam utha nahi uthaya jata. That this desire that has entered my heart to go closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is also the favor of Allah. One person in the marketplace, he bought some fish. He needed somebody to transport the fish back home for him. So he looked around for a laborer. He found someone, they agreed on a stipend. I'll pay you so much to transport this fish for me. As they were walking back towards his house, the azan was called out. When the azan was called out, the laborer said to the one that he employed him, allow me to go and make my salah. So he said, okay, no problem. He left the fish with him and he went into the masjid. Little while later, the people's salah was over, people started coming out. Yet the laborer procrastinated. He took very, very long. The person that had employed him got upset. So he shouted from outside the masjid, what is delaying you? What is keeping you inside the masjid? This person from inside the masjid responded that that being that is keeping you out of the masjid is the one that is keeping me in the masjid. Oh. Great Nabi of Allah, Shu'aib alayhi salam, in the Quran, what does he say? وَمَا تَوْفِيقِي إِلَّا بِاللَّهِ وَمَا تَوْفِيقِي إِلَّا بِاللَّهِ عَلَيْهِ تَوَكَّلْتُ وَإِلَيْهِ أُنِيبُ. Whatever I have done, Jalilul Qadr Nabi of Allah. Jalilul Qadr Nabi of Allah. What is he saying? Whatever I have done, it is with tawfiq from Allah. This heart is in Allah's control. Every aspect of the wujud and existence of this insan, from head to toe, one basic fundamental message, that of which Quran beautifully, succinctly sums up in one expression, Ya ayyuha an-nas, antumul fuqara'u ilallah, wallahu huwal ghaniyyul hamid. That, oh people, every one of you is faqir. Every one of you is a beggar. Every one of you possesses nothing. Every one of you is totally and completely reliant on Allah. Antumul fuqara'u ilallah. For every breath of air, these lungs, it is said are made up of 150 million air sacs. The lung of each human being, 150 million air sacs. If these lungs had to be opened up, they will fill a football field. This human being subconsciously breathes in and out 20,000 times every day. In and out, we don't even realize it. We are breathing in and out 20,000 times every day. What are we doing? We are absorbing from the atmosphere what? Oxygen, which is pure. The average human being absorbs 8,000 liters of oxygen every day. He takes oxygen out of the atmosphere. What is his contribution? What is his contribution? خَيْرِي إِلَى الْعِبَادِ نَازِلْ شَرُّهُمْ إِلَيَّ صَاعِدْ. Comes in the riwayat, Allah says, the best from me comes to you. The best from me comes to you and the worst from you comes back to me. Every aspect, if we analyze the life of this human being, he takes what is beneficial, he gives back that which is no benefit. Breathes in oxygen, which is pure, breathes out carbon dioxide, which is a poison, which is impure. 8,000 liters, imagine, if we had to pay for the oxygen that we are utilizing. Even if it was £1 a liter, 8,000 pounds a day, who's going to find? Every day, 8,000 liters of oxygen. We are breathing in oxygen, breathing out carbon dioxide, which is impure. This atmosphere, Allah has made it such, the level of oxygen is 21%. If it had to increase just 2% to 23%, then the number of accidental fires would increase 700 times. If it had to go 2% above that to 25%, besides the North Pole and the South Pole, everything in between will be burned to ashes. Centuries have passed, yet constantly the level of oxygen, which is conducive for this insan to survive and subsist in this world, is being kept at 21%. Where is the regulator? Where is the funnel? Where is the pipe? How is it that it is being kept constant? Where is the laboratory? One ni'mat of Allah. One bounty of Allah. We cannot even imagine the extent of Allah's favor. What a system. What a system Allah has put into place for this to happen. This earth. Many, many places in the Quran, Allah invites us. وَفِي الْأَرْضِ آيَاتٌ لِلْمُوقِنِينَ أَلَمْ نَجْعَلِ الْأَرْضَ مِهَادًا هُوَ الَّذِي جَعَلَ لَكُمُ الْأَرْضَ ذَلُولًا أَلَمْ نَجْعَلِ الْأَرْضَ كِفَاتًا أَحْيَاءُ وَأَمْوَاتًا وَالْأَرْضَ فَرَشْنَاهَا فَنِعْمَ الْمَاهِدُونَ. So many places Allah says, look at this earth, ponder over the earth. We have made it a cradle. We have made it comfort. We have created qarar, perhaps 14 centuries ago, for them to understand what Quran speaks about. When Allah says, qarar, we have created stability on this earth, perhaps they didn't fully comprehend it. Now with scientific advancement, it becomes clearer to understand what Quran means when Allah says, "Alam naj'al al-ardha qarara," huwa alladhi, that Allah has made this earth stable, a cradle for you. This earth is not still, it is spinning. Spinning at the speed of 1,000 kilometers an hour. Imagine something that's moving, spinning, 1,000 kilometers an hour. Moving outwards. One movement, it's spinning on its axis. Second movement, it is moving outwards. What speed? 108,000 kilometers an hour. 65,000 miles an hour, this earth is moving outward. The earth is round. Sometimes we look at the lizard on the roof and we think the lizard is upside down, we are upside down. Why aren't we flung into the atmosphere? Allah has created gravity. Allah has created stability on the earth. There is a third movement. There is a third movement of this earth. One, it is spinning on its axis. The third, second, it is moving outwards. There is a third movement. This earth is tilting. 23.5 degrees left, 23.5 degrees right. Tilting on its axis. What happens as a result of this third tilting? The four seasons are established. The variation of night and day is established. The waves of the ocean are established. Not my intention to go into a scientific lesson. A lot of times people get very worried when we start talking scientific things. But the Quran, throughout the Quran, Allah invites us, ponder, reflect. Those verses of the Quran were revealed. Aisha Ummul Mumineen radiallahu anha, Allah's Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the entire night was spent in salah. Was spent crying before Allah. When he was asked about that night, he said, "Why should it not be so? Allah has revealed these verses upon me." What verses? "Inna fi khalqi as-samawati wal-ard wa ikhtilafi al-layli wan-nahar la-ayat li-ulil al-albab alladhina yadhkuruna Allaha qiyaman wa qu'udan wa 'ala junubihim wa yatafakkaruna fi khalqi as-samawati wal-ard rabbana ma khalaqta hadha batila Subhanaka faqina azab al-nar." The revelation of these verses caused my Nabi not to sleep that entire night. What is Allah saying? Verily, in the creation of the heavens and the earth, in the variation of day and night, are signs. For whom? لِأُولِي الْأَلْبَابِ. For the people of intelligence. Who are the people of intelligence? Those who have university degrees. Those who have PhD, those who are Oxford University graduates or Harvard University graduates, or those who have a long list of titles and doctorates. This is a fallacy. This is a lie that is purported by the Batil institution, Batil machinery which is espousing this message 24 hours a day. That ilm and knowledge is degrees. Ilm and knowledge is worldly advancement. By the qasam of my Allah, by the qasam of my Allah, by the qasam of my Allah. Where does knowledge start? The first knowledge, the first ilm is the pehchan and the recognition of Allah. Knowledge starts with the recognition of Allah. Allah begins His kalam. Allah begins His Quran, Alif Lam Mim. Open any tafsir. Open any commentary of the Quran. Start the commentary of the Quran, Alif Lam Mim. What is the tafsir? Wallahu a'lamu bi muradihi. Allah knows best. In other words, where does knowledge start? With the i'tiraf and the recognition that we know nothing. Allah knows everything. Alif Lam Mim, Zalika al-Kitab la rayba fee. This is the book, in it is no doubt. Hudal lil-Muttaqeen, it is Hidayat. What is Hidayat? Hidayat is Noor. Hidayat is light. Hudal lil-Muttaqeen, it is Hidayat for the people of Taqwa. For the people of Allah's Ta'alluq, for the people of Allah's recognition. Where does Hidayat start? Where does Taqwa start? Where does Iman start? الَّذِينَ يُؤْمِنُونَ بِالْغَيْبِ. الذين يؤمنون بالغيب. That first selector arsh tak, from the earth to the arsh of Allah. Whether it is the river, whether it is the stream, whether it is the mountain. Look around us. How many indications, how many invitations towards the greatness and the qudrat of Allah. Coming back to what we were talking about, the third movement of the earth, tilting left, tilting right, tilting left, tilting right. If there were no waves in the ocean, the fruit will not ripen. The waxing and waning of the moon will not occur. This tilting, many, many benefits. One particular benefit which I am referring to is it creates the atmosphere. It creates the wind, the movement. If this Allah did not create this wind, each time insan breathed out, what you breathe out? Carbon dioxide, poison. If it were not for the third movement, the tilting of this earth, left, right, there would be no wind. So what would happen? The poison would get stuck in front of you. You breathe out again, more poison, then more poison, then more poison, till eventually you will suffocate in your own breath. Allah created a third movement in this earth to create the wind so that the poison is carried away from you. We cannot even reflect, ponder, realize the favors, the bounties of Allah. Breathing in, breathing out 20,000 times every day, taking out 8,000 liters of oxygen. Yet the level of oxygen stays constant. How? Why? Allah has put the leaves. Allah has put the leaves of the trees into the service of this insan. That leaf is green. Look at the sand, what is the color? Brown. Look at the water, what is the color? Look at the seed, what is the color? Look at the trunk and the branch of the tree, what is the color? How is it that the leaf turns green? Where's the dye factory? Where's the connection with the green paint? It needs to be green to carry out the function and task which Allah wants it to carry on. In that leaf, in that green leaf, a process of photosynthesis takes place, a chemical process that is so complex that it can never be replicated in any chemical laboratory of this world. That tiny leaf, Allah has placed that intelligence. What is it doing? It is taking a certain frequency of light. Light from the sun. Light from the sun is sifted. So that only a certain frequency reaches this earth. How, to what extent is it sifted? It is said the light from the sun is divided into 200 million parts. Only one part reaches the earth. That part which is beneficial for the insan. This leaf carries out a process of photosynthesis. It converts the carbon dioxide, the poison that you are breathing it out. It changes it into oxygen to keep the level of oxygen constant in this earth, 21%. Understand this and then look at the verse of the Quran where Allah says, Alam taraw, anna Allaha sakhara lakum ma fi samawati wa ma fi al-ard. Why don't you see the manner in which Allah has subjugated everything in the heavens, everything in the earth for you? Just this respiratory process of this insan, this breathing in, breathing out, the sun is working for you. The earth is working for you. The wind is working for you. The environment is working for you. The atmosphere is working for you. Every leaf of every tree is working for you. What does Allah say? 14 centuries ago, Allah in His Quran says, why don't you see the manner in which everything in the heavens and everything in the earth has been made musakhkhar for you in the earth? For you, my banda, for you, my slave, Allah has subjugated everything around us and put it to work for this insan. Huwa alladhi khalaqa lakum ma fil ardi jami'a. Allah says, we created everything in this earth for you, insan. Such favors, such bounties of Allah are raining down. Wa asbagha alaykum ni'amahu zahiratan wa batina. Allah says, why don't you observe the manner in which our ni'mat and our bounties are raining down upon you? Barish ki tarah. Like rainwater, our ni'mat and our bounties, every droplet of rainwater, was sahabil musakhkhar, والسحاب المسخر. Quran invites you, look at those clouds. Cumulonimbus is the name of one rain cloud. It contains 300 million tons of water. 300 million tons of water contained in one rain cloud suspended above you. Why don't you drown? Why doesn't it fall? The entire Niagara Falls passes over your head while you are sleeping at night. Where is it? What is that system that is keeping it suspended? And then when Allah decides for rain, Anna sababana al-ma'a sabba. Look, what does Quran say? Look at the expression. Look at the mode of expression of Quran. Anna sababana al-ma'a sabba. Allah says, why don't you observe the beautiful manner in which we cause rain to fall? What is Quran telling us about rainfall? It is said, an object the size of a rain droplet. An object the size of a rain droplet. The average height of rain cloud is 1200 meters above the ground. Something the size of a rain droplet, if you drop it from an altitude of 1200 meters, when it strikes the earth, it should be traveling at 558 kilometers an hour. Bullet travels at 1670 kilometers an hour. Almost half the speed of a bullet is what speed the rain droplet should be traveling at. What will happen? Your cars will get destroyed. Your crops will get destroyed. Your houses will get destroyed. These old, old buildings that are lasting in England, same color, they're coming over the years. Some of them get sandblasted, but still the same. Absolutely desolate environment. All this will get destroyed. If the rain droplet was allowed to fall at the speed it is supposed to fall. But what has Allah done? Allah has put speed breakers. Speed breakers. Atmosphere has been designed in such a way so that the rain droplet, its speed is broken, so that instead of landing at 558 kilometers an hour, when it strikes the ground, it is striking at 8 to 10 kilometers an hour. Softly, like they say, you read, when as you are growing up, especially when they talk about rain in England, they say, putta patta, putta patta, putta patta. As softly landing on the ground, what is that putta patta? What is that putta patta? Wallah, my respected brothers, that putta patta is what? La ilaha illallah. La ilaha illallah. La ilaha illallah. Every droplet of rainwater, every droplet of rainwater is announcing to you, inna lihada al-khalqi khaliq. Inna lihada al-khalqi khaliq. Sanurihim ayatina fil afaqi wa fi anfusihim hatta yatabayyana lahum annahu al-haq. Allah says, we will show you our signs in the horizons and within yourselves until it will become apparent that one haqiqi Allah is the designer of everything. Nothing exists without the permission of Allah. Qul huwa Allahu ahad. The Quraysh of Makkah, they came to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Came to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The Arabs were very, very carried away, interested in this issue of lineage. They had a lot of pride about their lineage. I'm the son of so and so, the son of so and so. It will go back 10, 15 generations. So they came to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. They said, make bayan, expound, elucidate, explain. What is the lineage of Allah? What is Allah's lineage? Immediately Jibreel is sent with the surah of the Quran. Short surah. Mufassirin say thuluthul Quran. This surah is one third of the Quran. Two reasons for that ulama give. One is a person who recites it three times will get the reward of the entire Quran. The other reason or explanation ulama gives is that the maqsad of nubuwwat, if it has to be analyzed, normally is broken up into three parts. Tawheed, Allah's oneness. Risalat, the way of life of the Nabi. And akhirat, the conviction of akhirat. They say that one third of the maqsad of nubuwwat, that mazmoon and topic, is the topic of the surah. Tawheed, the oneness of Allah. What make bayan is yesterday to explain what is the lineage of Allah. Jibreel is sent. Qul, tell them, who Allah. He is Allah. Allah introduces himself. Allah gives you his own name. Who Allah. He is Allah. Who Allah, who Ahad. Ahad, normally what we translate is one. Allah is one. That translation is incorrect. It does not do justice to the meaning of Ahad. Because if there is one, there can be two. And if there's two, there can be three. Ahad. What is Ahad? Ulama say, explain. Laysa ka mithlihi shay. There is nothing that is like Allah. Allah is unique. Human beings, normally our psyche is such. What we tend to quantify things, compare things. If you are impressed about something, we compare it with something else that impresses us. Brighter than the sun, faster than the wind, more rapid than lightning, more beautiful than the moon. Comparison. Ahad. When it comes to Allah, there is no comparison. Laysa kamithlihi shay. There is no similitude with Allah. That personality, Wahab bin Munabba says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ تَعَالَى لَمْ يُعْتِ جَمِيعَ النَّاسِ مِنْ بَدِ الدُّنْيَا إِلَىٰ إِنْقِضَائِهَا مِنَ الْعَقْلِ فِي جَنْبِ عَقْلِهِ إِلَّا كَحَبَّةِ رَمْلٍ بَيْنَ رِمَالِ الدُّنْيَا. He said it's the combined uqul and intelligence of every human being. From Adam alayhi salam to the last person to come before Qiyamah, if every human being's intelligence had to be pulled together and equated to one grain of sand, then the aql and intelligence of Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would be all the grains of sand on the surface of the earth. That intelligence, and what does he say? Allahumma la astati'u thana'an alayk anta kama athnayta ala nafsik. O Allah, I also cannot praise you as you ought to be praised. La yasifuhu alwasifun. No one can describe the greatness of Allah. Akbar min kulli kabir, aqwa min kulli qawi, az min kulli aziz, azam min kulli azim, ajal min kulli jaleel. Greater than anything with greatness. More majestic than anything with majesty. More powerful than anything with power. More mighty than anything with mighty. More with might. More glorious than anything with glory. وَهُوَ الَّذِي فِي السَّمَاءِ إِلَهِ وَفِي الْأَرْضِ إِلَهِ. He is the ilah of the heavens. He is the ilah of the earth. Uloom and knowledge starts with what? The pehchan of Allah. The recognition of Allah. Unfortunately, the so-called educational institutions of this world, what are they espousing? A for apple, B for bottle. Where does knowledge start? Like in the, even when they teach Urdu also, some of them are familiar with Urdu, alif say anad, ba say bottle. Why not alif for Allah? Why not alif for Allah? Why not A for Allah? Where does knowledge start? Knowledge starts with the recognition of Allah. Na ayatil liulil albab. In the creation of the heavens and the earth, in variation of day and night, are signs for people of intelligence. Who are the people of intelligence? Where does knowledge start? Where does intelligence start? الَّذِينَ يَذْكُرُونَ اللَّهَ قِيَامًا وَقُعُودًا وَعَلَىٰ جُنُوبِهِمْ وَيَتَفَكَّرُونَ فِي خَلْقِ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ رَبَّنَا مَا خَلَقْتَ هَذَا بَاطِلًا سُبْحَانَكَ فَقِنَا عَذَابَ النَّارِ. Who are the people of intelligence? They are those who remember Allah. Who see the greatness of Allah standing, sitting on their side. They ponder and reflect over the creation of the heavens and the earth. And eventually they will reach one conclusion. Oh my Allah, you have not created this in vain. Save us from the azab of Jahannam. This life is temporary. This life is ephemeral. An ordinary Bedouin, Dihati, what we call Arab. Nomadic background, desert dweller. His entire life, No formal education. He comes into Masjid al-Nabawi, raises his hands, starts making dua. Look at the manner in which he praises Allah. Wallah, you can write a PhD and a doctorate explaining the manner in which this ordinary person praises Allah. We haven't understood what is knowledge. Knowledge is not PhD. If I ask the Harvard University graduate, by how many eyes you got? He says two. How many nose you got? One. How many ears you got? Two. How many hair on your head? How many hair in your head? Where's the empirical evidence? Can you use a computer? Or use some gadget to establish how many hair on the head? What the length of each hair is? How many hair on my head, your head? How many hair on the head of every human being? There was, there is, or there will be. All this is in Allah's knowledge. عليم بذات الصدور عالم الغيب والشهادة كل صغير وكبير مستطر يعلم ما بين أيديهم وما خلفهم ألا يعلم من خلق وعنده مفاتح الغيب لا يعلمها إلا هو ويعلم ما في البر والبحر وما تسقط من ورقة إلا يعلمها ولا حبة في ظلمات الأرض ولا رطب ولا يابس إلا في كتاب مبين. How many places in the Quran Allah opens up his knowledge? Allah has knowledge of everything that was, that is, that will be. Every count is in the knowledge of Allah. Each facet of His creation, sagheer wa kabir, small or big, insignificant or prominent, mustatar is recorded in the knowledge of Allah. Group of German scientists, 25 years ago they got together. Millions of dollars were spent, years of exhaustive research to understand the function of one cell in the body, what we call the beta cell in the pancreas, which produces insulin. After years of exhaustive research, they threw in the towel and they said, we cannot understand the function of one cell. Allah has made this human being a composition of 100 trillion cells. 100 trillion cells is one human being. They couldn't understand the function of one cell. What knowledge does insan have? قُلْ هَلْ عِنْدَكُمْ مِنْ عِلْمٍ فَتُخْرِجُوهُ لَنَا إِن تَتَّبِعُونَ إِلَّا الظَّنِّ وَإِنْ أَنْتُمْ إِلَّا تَخْرُسُونَ. Allah challenges us to tell them that if you have knowledge, then produce it. What you are following is doubt. What you are following is conjecture. What is knowledge? What is knowledge? That which reached us from the arsh of Allah, untainted by human hand, through the agency of Janabi Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Knowledge is Quran, tanzeel, revelation. It is coming down. Mimman khalaqa al-ardha was-samawati al-ula. الرحمن على العرش استوى له ما في السماوات وما في الأرض وما بينهما وما تحت الثرى وإن تجهر بالقول فإنه يعلم السر وأخفى الله لا إله إلا هو له الأسماء الحسنى. Such a Quran. Unfortunately, my respected brothers, we cannot lament sufficiently the lack of munasabat of this ummah with Quran. Our elders are telling us, aaj Quran ek na ashna peygham ban chuki. Quran has become an irrelevant message. Somebody opens up a new shop, read a little bit Quran Sharif. You think somebody got jadu asar or jinn asar, read few ayat and blow on it. Ramadan comes, little bit Quran is taken out. But the sharaf of Quran, the attachment of Quran, the day of Quran, the night of Quran, this is that message from Allah that Allah says, لو أنزلنا هذا القرآن على جبل لرأيته خاشعا متصدعا من خشية الله. Allah says, if you had to reveal this Quran on a mountain, the mountain would be rent asunder from the fear of Allah. I always give this example. One person, he went to the Mulisa, he said, Mulisa, make dua for my son. Mulisa makes dua, Ya Allah, make the son of so and so a muazzin. Man gets upset. He says, I told you to make dua, not badwa. Muazzin. Why didn't you say doctor, lawyer, chemical engineer, astrophysicist, engineer? Muazzin. What they say some places, bangisa. You don't even like to translate what that means. Yet what is the reality? What is the reality? Allah's Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the body of the doctor and the lawyer and the engineer and the astrophysicist will become the food and the fodder of the insects of the grave. Allah has made the body of a muazzin haram on the insects of the grave. لا يدود في قبره لا يدود في قبره أطول الناس أعناقا يوم القيامة المؤذنون. The people with the longest necks, the highest rank on the day of judgment will be those who used to call out adhan. Allahumma rabba hadhi da'wati tamma. Why azan is complete, perfect da'wat. Allah will give them the highest ranks. The value systems of this ummah are gone upside down. ألا وإنكم جعلتم نسبا وجعلت نسبي جعلت أكرمكم أتقاكم ولكن أبيتم وقلتم إن فلان ابن فلان خير من فلان ابن فلان اليوم أبوا نسبكم وأرفع نسبي أين المتقون أين الذين تتجافى جنوبهم عن المضاجع أين الصائمون On that day the announcement will take place that listen you people had one basis of respect dignity and honor and we had one basis What was your basis? The one who wore the Hugo Boss suit. The one who drove around with a fancy car. The one who had 6 or 7 zeros in his bank balance, you looked up to him. And the one who didn't have a roof over his head, didn't have a pillow underneath his head. His clothes were simple, you looked down upon him. That which our elders are telling us, they say, insan ke qeemat andar ke sarmaya se hote, bahar ke sarmaya se nahi. The value of this human being is not what is outside, is what is inside. Right, Fuller gets, come closer, mashallah.
Yes, sir.
Come, right, create a little bit of space. There is a lot of space inside, in the back. Those can come inside, inshallah. Like the poet says, يَمْشِي الْفَقِيرُ وَكُلُّ شَيْءٍ ضِدُّهُ تراه مبغضا وليس بمذنب يرى العداوة ولا يرى أسبابها حتى أن الكلاب إذا رأت ذا ثروة خضعت لديه وحركت أذنابها وإذا رأت يوما فقيرا غابرا نبحت عليه وقشرت أنيابها He says the poor man walks and the whole world is against him. The poor man walks and the whole world is against him. He sees the manner in which you scoff at him and look down upon him, yet he has not committed any crime. يَرَى الْعَدَاوَةَ وَلَا يَرَى أَسْبَابَهَا He sees your dislike, he doesn't know what the cause. And such an effort of this batil machinery, espousing this message 24 hours a day. What message? Paisa ho to kaam banega, paisa ho to kaam banega. Paisa ho to kaam banega. Acquire the material things of this world. Acquire the wealth of this world. In this is success. In this is dignity. In this is honor. Such an effort of batil is taking place. Once one jamaat went to somebody's house. Outside the house there were two cars parked. One was a Mercedes Benz, the other was a Toyota. There were some few children playing. So the Rebbe of the Jamaat asked the five-year-old girl, Where's your papa? The five-year-old child pushes her chest out and she points to the Mercedes Benz and she says, This is my papa's car. This is my papa's car. Seems like a simple, innocent statement. But at the age of five already, such an effort, such an environment we are living in. At the age of five already, this child distinguishes a status symbol difference between a Mercedes Benz and a Toyota. Imagine, my respected brothers, if that incorrect yaqeen is left unchecked. By the time she's 25, 30, 35, 40, what will be the yaqeen in the heart? What will be the reality of the yaqeen in the heart? Such an environment exists that the poet says, even the dog, when it sees the rich man, it wags its tail, stretches out its forepaw. When it sees the poor man, the vagabond, starts barking and chasing it. This mentality that distinguishes the status and position of a human being on the basis of worldly means, on the basis of worldly wealth, in reality is the mentality of a dog or an animal. Anbiya alayhi salatu was salam made efforts on what? On inside. The value of this human being is what is inside. Inna allaha la yanzur ila suwarikum. Allah will not look at what is external. Allah looks at what is inside. Allah's Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam on one occasion, he's sitting with Sahaba, Abdullah bin Mas'ud radiallahu ta'ala, who comes. He was nahiful jasam, very, very thin. His legs were thin, shins. His shins were like pegs. The wind blows, his lungi lifts up. One or two Sahaba giggle when they see the thin shins of Abdullah bin Mas'ud. Allah's Rasul looks at them and he says something to this effect: you are grinning or you are laughing at the thin shins of Abdullah bin Mas'ud. وَالَّذِي نَفْسُ مُحَمَّدٍ بِيَدِهِ إِنَّهُمَا لَأَثْقَلُ فِي الْمِيزَانِ مِنْ جَبَلِ أُحَدٍ. By the qasam of that being whose hands lies the life of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the two shins of Abdullah bin Mas'ud will be weightier on the scale of deeds than the mountain of Uhud. Why? What was inside? What was inside? Insan ke qeemat andar ke samaya se bante hai. The value of this human being is what is inside. Ordinary Bedouin. When the noor and the marifat of iman enters the heart, look at the manner in which he praises Allah. Even a doctorate or a Harvard University graduate cannot even write a doctorate to explain the manner in which he praises Allah. Ya man la tarahu al-uyun, wala tukhalituhu al-dhunun, wala yasifuhu al-wasifun, wala tughayiruhu al-hawadith, wala yakhsha al-dawair. Ya man ya'lamu mathaqil al-jibal, wa makail al-bihar, wa adad qatr al-amtar, wa adad warq al-ashjar, wa adad ma azlama alayhi al-layl, wa ashraqa alayhi al-nahar, wala tuwari minhu سماء سماء ولا أرض أرضا ولا بحر ما في قعره ولا جبل ما في وعره. الله أكبر. Look at the manner in which he praises Allah. He says, oh my Allah, your greatness, your majesty is such that the eyeballs cannot encompass you. You are beyond eyesight. يَا مَنْ لَا تَرَاهُ الْعُيُونَ. Eyesight is still limited. Eyesight is a weak faculty which Allah has given insan. Much more stronger than eyesight is the imaginative ability of this human being. What we call quwwat al-khiyal or quwwat al-takhayyul, the imaginative ability of insan, this is something on which Allah has placed no limitation. This is an amusing example to give. They say there were three people, they went in the jungle. They had one bowl of milk between the three of them. Night time came, they got into argument about its distribution. So they said, okay, whoever sees the best dream can decide how to distribute it. To protect it, they put it on a high branch, went to sleep. Next morning, they got up, asked the first person, what did you dream? He says, last night I went to the first heaven. Obviously, he didn't dream anything, this is his imagination. Second person, what did you dream? He says, I went to the fourth heaven. Third person said, I'm too afraid to tell you my dream. They said, they insisted, this was a condition, you have to tell us. He says, last night when I was sleeping, all of a sudden I was woken up. My horseman had a long spear in his hand, pointed it to my neck and said, if you want to save your life, bring the bowl of milk down. He said, my life was in danger. What was I going to do? I had no choice. I brought the milk down. He said, start drinking, otherwise I'm going to kill you. He said, I started drinking, but I just sipped. I thought I'd leave some for my friends. There was no taste or sweetness in the milk. He said, drink till the last drop, otherwise I'm going to kill you. He says, my life was in danger. I had to finish it all up. He said, why didn't you call for help? He says, I shouted and shouted. You were in the first heaven. He was in the fourth heaven. Quwwat al-khiyal, that is that ability of the human being on which Allah has placed no limitation. Ordinary Bedouin, nomadic background, look at the manner in which he praises Allah. He says, Ya man la tarahu al-uyun, wa la tukhalituhu al-dhunun, wa la yasifuhu al-wasifun. He says, oh my Allah, if I imagine and imagine and imagine, I will never be able to imagine your greatness. If I try and praise and describe to the limit of the ability of this human being to praise, I will never be able to praise you as you ought to be praised. Ali radiallahu anhu is giving khutbah in Yemen. He's giving khutbah in Kufa. A Yemeni stands up. He has inad, dushmani with Ali radiallahu anhu. So he poses a question, trying na'udhu billah to make a fool of Ali radiallahu anhu. What question does he ask? He says, Ya Ali, hal tara rabbak? Ali, have you seen Allah? Ali, have you seen Allah? Who is Ali? Ali is that personality in whose mouth the lu'ab mubarak, the pure saliva of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was put. Ulama say through the barakat of that, يَتَفَجَّرُ الْعِلْمُ مِنْ جَوَانِبِهِ وَتَنْتِقُ الْحِكْمَةُ عَنْ نَوَاحِيهِ. The ulum and the knowledge of deen would flow from the limbs of Ali. Hikmat would be in the vestiges of the veins of the body of Ali radiallahu. One night, he started making tafsir of Surah Fatiha. This was the barakat of the lu'ab mubarak of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He started making tafsir of Surah Fatiha after Isha Salah. The azan for Fajr was called out and he had not completed the tafsir of the Ba of Bismillah. He said, Allah has given me such knowledge that if I had to dictate the tafsir of Surah Fatiha and you people had to write it out, write it down on scrolls, you will require 70 camels just to transport the scroll. Tafsir of one surah of the Quran. That knowledge Allah gave him. When this question was asked, Ali, hal tara rabbak? Have you seen Allah? He immediately understood that the intention of this person was incorrect. So he gave an answer, a response in a similar vein. What was his answer? He says, ma kuntu a'budu rabban lam arahu. He said, if I had not seen Allah, I would not have worshipped Allah. If I had not seen Allah, I would not have worshipped Allah. Now everyone is shocked. What does Ali mean? Quran says, لَا تُدْرِكُهُ الْأَبْصَارِ وَهُوَ يُدْرِكُ الْأَبْصَارِ. The eyeballs cannot encompass Allah. And what is Ali saying? If I had not seen Allah, I would not have worshipped Allah. They say, Ali, what do you mean? Allahu Akbar, what does he say? لَمْ تَرَهُ الْعُيُونَ بِمُشَاهَدَةِ الْعَيَانِ وَلَكِنْ رَأَتْهُ الْقُلُوبِ بِحَقِيقَةِ الْإِيمَانِ رَبِّي أَخَذٌ لَا شَرِيكَ لَهُ فَرْدٌ لَا نِدْلَ لَهُ لَمْ يُدْرَكْ بِالْحَوَاسِ وَلَا يُقَاسُ بِالْقِيَاسِ. By the Qasam of my Allah, no language can do justice to the translation of what he said. The crux of what he said, the physical eye has not seen Allah, but I have seen my Allah through the reality of my iman, through the eye of my heart. The eye of my heart has seen my Allah. كَذَبَ مَنِ الدَّعَى مَحَبَّتِي كَذَبَ مَنِ الدَّعَى مَحَبَّتِي. Now, sir, it is mentioned, Allah, Hadith Qudsi, Allah says, the one that says that he loves me, the one that says that he loves me, فَإِذَا جَنَّهُ اللَّيْلِ نَامَ عَنِّي. But when nightfall descends, he's sleeping the whole night. He does not get onto the musalla and cry before Allah at the time of tahajjud. Allah says he is a liar. كَذَبَ مَنِ الدَّعَى مَحَبَّتِي فَإِذَا جَنَّهُ اللَّيْلِ نَامَ عَنِّي. The one who truly loves Allah, when he will get up at the night, when you get up at night and go on the musalla and cry before Allah, it is mentioned in the Asr, what happens, what happens, what happens? Allah says, I open his heart to the reality of my love. He is in munajat, he is talking directly to Allah. Ahmad bin Abi Khawari comes to Abu Sulaiman Darani rahmatullah alayh and he finds him crying. He says to him, why are you crying? He says, oh Ahmad, what must I tell you? إِذَا جَنَّ اللَّيْلِ وَاخْتَلَتَ الظَّلَامِ وَخَلَى كُلُّ حَبِيبٍ بِحَبِيبِهِ. When the nightfall descends, the night drops its curtains, the darkness becomes intense, every lover goes into solitude with his beloved. They are some true slaves of Allah. The ish, the fire of Allah's ish, the fire of Allah's muhabbat, the fire of Allah's ta'alluq does not allow them to remain on their bed. In the dead of night, nasabu ilayya aqdamahum, waftarashu ilayya jibahahum, fabayna mutaawihin wa baqin wa sarikhin wa shakin. In the dead of night, they get up, they go on the musalla, sometimes they are in sajda, sometimes they are in ruku, sometimes they are whispering, sometimes they are shouting, sometimes they are exulting. Those hot tears are pouring down their cheeks. To the onlooker, to the observer, what does it appear? This man is suffering. This man is in grief. This man is in sorrow. He is crying. He is sobbing. There is some taklif. There is some pain. There is some hardship. But wallah, 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 by the qasam of my Allah, in the dead of night, on that musalla, with those hot tears pouring down his cheeks, Allah gives him that ecstasy. Allah gives him that sweetness. Allah gives him that enjoyment in his heart that wallah cannot be found anywhere else in this world. That is why Ibrahim bin Adam rahimahullah used to say, Ahlul layli fi laylihim, Ahlul layli fi laylihim, Aladhu min ahlil lahwi fi lahwihim. The people of tahajjud salah, the people of the night, the people of Allah's ta'alluq, Allah gives them that lazzat and ecstasy which can never be found in the dens of vice and the dens of haram. Ibn Taymiyyah rahmatullah used to say, there is one jannat There is one Jannat. There is one Jannat in this world. Till you don't enter this Jannat, you will not enter the Jannat of Akhirah. What is that Jannat? The Jannat of the ecstasy of standing on the Musalla at the dead of night and crying before Allah. Our elders are telling us the greatest adab, the greatest etiquette of this work of Dawat and Tabligh is Tahajjud Salah. To get up in the dead of night and cry before Allah, like Rasulullah Pak sallallahu alayhi wa sallam cried before Allah. First verses that were revealed after Iqra, after the first five verses of the Quran where Allah informed him that he was his Nabi. What were the first verses after that? Ya ayyuhal muzzammil, qum al-layla illa qaleela, nisfahu aw inqus minhu qaleela, aw zid alayhi wa rattil al-Qur'ana tartila, inna sanulqi alayka qawlan thaqila, inna nashiyata al-layl hiya ashadd wat'an wa aqwam qila, inna laka fi an-nahari sabhan tawila, wadhkur isma rabbika wa tabattal ilayhi tabtila. Oh my Nabi, who covers himself in a cloth, stand up before Allah. Qum al-layla illa qaleela. Stand up at night before Allah. Recite the Quran before Allah. Where is the munasabat with Quran today? Where is the attachment of this ummah with Quran today? Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Man ja'alahu amamahu saqahu ila al-jannah, man ja'alahu khalfahu saqahu ila al-nar." He said, "This Quran is such, if my ummah will keep it in front of them, it will take them to Jannah. If they will put it behind their backs, it will take them towards Jahannam." Tabi'i says, "I stood in the Haram of Makkah behind Osman Ghani radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Osman began Tahajjud Salah. I stood behind him. He began Surah Fatiha. He says, by the Qasam of my Allah, by the Qasam of my Allah, Osman did not go into Ruku until he reached Surah Nas. The entire Quran in one rakat of Tahajjud Salah." Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam would say, what would he say? He would say, "Ya Allah has kept my lazzat, Allah has kept my ecstasy fi qiyam al-layl, in the standing of in standing on the musalla before Allah at night." Usman radiyallahu ta'ala would say, Lo tahurat qulubukum, ma shabi'tum min kalam Allahi azza wa jal. He would say, if your hearts were pure, you would never get tired. You would never get tired of listening to Quran. Ramadan is coming. Where is the shagaf and attachment of the ummah to the Quran? I remember a few years ago, we were going one town for Taraweeh Salah. Outside the masjid, they had two signposts. We're not here to get into any fiqhi ikhtilaf or fiqhi difference. Ulama know better. But unfortunately, वो आदमी जिसको इस्तिंजा करना भी अच्छी तरह नहीं जानते हैं, that person who doesn't even know how to make इस्तिंजा in Ramadan becomes a mufti. Some of them become even bigger muftis than Umar radiallahu ta'ala. Outside the masjid, two signposts. One signpost arrow this way, parking for 8 rakats. Other side, parking for 20 rakats. We're not here to get into the ikhtilaf or difference that Allah knows best, ulama know better. But where is the sharaf for the Quran? Where is the attachment for the Quran? Allah's Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, for every sajda of Taraweeh Salah, Allah will give you 1500 hasanat. 1500 hasanat. 20 rakats, 40 sajda every night, 60,000 hasanat. If the announcement had to be made that by first Ramzan, Zakaria Masjid in Dewsbury, after Taraweeh Salah, underneath the Musalla will be 1500 pounds, what will happen? Nana, Nani, Dada, Dadi, the old, infirm, senile, they also will come to the masjid. There won't be space. Why? Because we know the value of maal. We know the value of maal, we don't know the value of amal. One subhanallah. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, subhanallah, mithlu jabali uhudin dhahaban fil jannah. He said, one subhanallah is equivalent to the mountain of Uhud in gold in Jannah. 14 kilometer long mountain range in gold, one subhanallah. This ummah's value system is gone upside down. That day the announcement will be made. Listen, you people had one basis of distinction and honor. We had one basis. What was your basis? The Hugo Boss suit, the fancy car, you looked up at him. The one who didn't have dunya, you looked down upon him. Allah, on that day the announcement will be made. Al-yawm abu nasabakum wa arfa'u nasabi. Today your system of respect and honor has come to an end. Our system will be established. Where are the people of taqwa? Where are the people who got up in the dead of night and cried before Allah? One occasion, Ibn Qayyim rahimullah mentions this riwayat. Rasulullah says to his sahaba, Ala ukhbirukum birijalikum min ahli al-jannah. He says, oh my sahaba, should I not tell you who the men of Jannah are? Should I not tell you who the men of Jannah are? Sahaba said, man hum ya Rasulullah? Who are the men of Jannah? He said, al-Nabiyu fi al-Jannah. والصديق في الجنة والشهيد في الجنة. He said the Nabi is in Jannah, Siddiq is in Jannah, Shaheed is in Jannah. And then what did he say? Sometimes we hear the اعلان, bhai baqiya namaz ke baad gash ke amal hoga. What does this mean? Look for the exit. Hum bayan mein baithenge, hum dekhenge. Where is the value system of the ummah today? What did Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam say? Nabi is in Jannah, Siddiq is in Jannah, Shaheed is in Jannah. والرجل الذي يزور أخاه في ناحية المصر لا يزوره إلا لله في الجنة. He says, Allah's Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam says, one ziyarat, one gash, one mulaqat in one corner of the city for the sake of Allah. On that mulaqat, Allah gives you Jannah. لا تحقرن من المعروف شيئا لا تحقرن من المعروف شيئا. Do not belittle any good deed. This ummah's value system has gone upside down. اليوم أبو نسبكم أرفع نسبي. Your system of respect has come to an end. Our system will be established. We are the people of tahajjud. We are the people who should get up in the dead of night. Where are the people of Amal? أين الذين تتجافى جنوبهم عن المضاجع? Where are those whose backs would be separated from their beds in the dead of night? Ahmad bin Abi al-Huwari says to Abu Sulaiman Darani says to Ahmad bin Abi al-Huwari, نسبوا إلي أقدامهم وافترشوا إلي جباههم فبين متوه وباك وصارخ وشاك. Sometimes they are crying, sometimes they are whispering, sometimes they are exulting. He says Allah addresses them, أول ما Allah says to Jibreel, Ya Jibreel, man talazzaza bi kalami wastaraha ila munajati. Those who get lazzat out of speaking to me, who get rahat out of my munajat, awwalu ma u'tihim, the first thing I will give them, an aqdhifa min nuri fi qulubihim, I will put my noor in their heart. والثاني لو كانت السماوات السبع والأرضين السبع في موازينهم لاستقللتها لهم. If the seven heavens and the seven earth had to be put in their scale of good deeds, I would still regard this to be too less for them. And the third thing, Allah says the day of judgment will come, it will be me and them. I will say to them, ask me whatever you want, whatever you want will be granted. This is not an ordinary ummah. That Bedouin praises Allah. Look at the manner in which he praises, oh my Allah, your greatness is such that the eyeballs cannot see you. The imagination cannot encompass or color you in any shape or form. You know the weight of the mountain. You know the measure of the seas. You know the number of rain droplets that are falling from the heavens. You know the number of leaves on the surface of the earth. One layer of heaven does not conceal from you what is above it. One stratum of the earth does not conceal from you what is beneath it. There isn't a green or a fresh thing, a dry or a withered thing in the heavens and the earth, but that it is in your knowledge. Allahu Akbar, when this ordinary Bedouin praises Allah in this manner, Allah's Rasul has some sense for him. He says to Abu Huraira, fetch two coins of gold. And he gives it to him. And when he presents it to him, Allah's Rasul asks him, do you know why I am giving you this? Do you know why I am giving you this? He says, perhaps because we are related. Perhaps because we are related. He says, no. Bi husni thana'ika ala Allah. Bi husni thana'ika ala Allah. Because of the beautiful manner in which you praise my Allah. Allah's Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam got into Wajd and presented him with this gift because he praised Allah. Can we imagine what Allah will give? What Allah will give? Is this heart beating with what? Ayatil ulil albab. Allah says they are signs for the people of intelligence. Who are they? Remember Allah standing, sitting on their sides. Ponder over the, reflect over the creation of Allah, over the heavens and the earth. Everything around us is inviting us. Recognize the greatness of Allah. Recognize the qudrat of Allah. Recognize the power of Allah. Hazrat Maulana Yusuf Sahib Rahmatullah Alayhi used to say, "Hum isliye nahi kehte hain ki Allah ki barai bayan karo, kyunki ye ek scheme hai, jiske zariye se ab logo ko chille aur teen chille ke liye taiyar karenge. We are not saying to you speak of Allah's greatness because this is some scheme by which you will prepare people for chille and three chille. No, hum isliye kehte hain ki Allah ki barai bayan karo, kyunki Allah ka haq hai ki uske tarah na kiya jaye." مخلوق کا ذکر بیماری ہے, خالق کا ذکر اس کے علاج ہے. اسے say, we are saying to you speak of Allah's greatness because it is the right of Allah. It is the right of Allah that his praises should be sung. To speak of the creation is a sickness. Stand outside the masjid and listen to the youngsters today. This sports personality, that person, that pop star, people whose every day is in sharab. Every night is in zina, are being idolized. He goes to the barber makes a mistake, that becomes the new hairstyle. He falls down, tears his jeans or his pants, the youngster is cutting his pants, why? My, so and so. Morally decrepit, bankrupt individuals are being idolized. Stand in the masjid, observe, look at the t-shirt. The youngster goes in sajda, his whole behind is exposed. Whether the namaz is made or Allah knows best. What direction is this ummah going in? Who have we made our imams? Who have we made our guides? Who are we following? That personality who finished himself for us. That personality who gave everything. No mother, wallah, no mother cried for her child. No father cried for his child like Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam cried for his ummah. Such maqam, such status. This month of Rajab, normally what we speak of Mi'raj al-Nabi. What a miracle, where, what maqam, what status did Allah take him? Subhanalladhi asra bi'abdihi laylan min al-masjid al-haram ila al-masjid al-aqsa. From masjid al-haram to masjid al-aqsa. The clock was stopped, time was stopped. Taken to that maqam, that status, how vast. How vast is this universe, this galaxy, what we call the Milky Way, which we are living in. We look at the earth, we think the earth is vast. Look up at the sun is 125,000 times the size of the earth. 1,392,000 kilometers is the diameter of the sun, and the sun is only one star. There are some stars in this system, this galaxy. This solar system, what we call the Milky Way. There are some stars, the diameter is 400 million kilometers. There is one star, the diameter is 1.4 billion kilometers. The sun is like a speck of dust in front of that star. Such a vast space, this galaxy, scientists estimate there are 200 billion stars. And the space is so vast, if you travel at the speed of light, light travels at 186,282 miles per second at that speed. 300,000 kilometers a second. In 1 year, you will cover a distance of 9.5 trillion kilometers. It is said this galaxy, just this one galaxy in which we are, is a distance of 150,000 light years. And they estimate there are 170 billion other such galaxies. And this comprises only 3% of the visible universe. The other 97% is invisible, what we call the black hole. The density of the matter in the black hole is such that one tablespoon of that matter, the density is more than the other 3% of the universe. And all this is sama'ud dunya, beneath the first heaven. Still the first heaven, second heaven, third heaven, fourth heaven, fifth heaven, sixth heaven, seventh heaven. Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, without an astronaut suit, without any outward protection, is taken Masjid al-Haram to Masjid al-Aqsa through the first heaven meets Adam alayhi salam. Then on the second heaven, Yahya and Isa alayhi salam. Then on the third heaven, Yusuf alayhi salam. Then on the fourth heaven, Idris alayhi salam. Then on the fifth heaven, Harun alayhi salam. Then in the sixth heaven, Musa alayhi salam. Then in the seventh heaven, Ibrahim alayhi salam. Then above that, right up till the Sidratul Muntaha, that point beyond which no creation of Allah had ever ventured, Jibreel says to him, Ya Rasulullah, if I go any further, I will be burnt to ashes. There is only permission for one creation of Allah to go beyond this point, and that is Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Qazi Ayaz rahimahullah in his Shifa mentions the riwayat, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam went beyond the Sidratul Muntaha. All of a sudden he says, Faraqani Jibreel, Faraqani Jibreel, Jibreel left me. I was completely alone, total, complete solitude. One qata'atil aswat, there was complete silence. He had reached that point no creation of Allah had ever reached. Naturally one will become afraid. All of a sudden, فَسَمِعْتُ كَلَامَ رَبِّي فَسَمِعْتُ كَلَامَ رَبِّي I heard the kalam of my Rabb, of my Allah. لِيَهْدَأْ رَوْعُكْ لِيَهْدَأْ رَوْعُكْ يَا حَبِيبِي أُذْنُ Do not be afraid, O my beloved. Do not be afraid, O my beloved. That maqam, that qurb. And then he speaks to Allah, Ya Rabbi, اتَّخَذْتَ إِبْرَاهِيمَ خَلِيلًا وَآتَيْتَهُ مُلْكًا عَظِيمًا وَكَلَّمْتَ مُوسَى تَكْلِيمًا وَآتَيْتَ دَاوُودَ مُلْكًا عَظِيمًا وَأَلَنْتَ لَهُ الْحَدِيدِ وَآتَيْتَ سُلَيْمَانَ مُلْكًا لَا يَنْبَغِي لِأَحَدٍ مِّن بَعْدِهِ وَسَخَّرْتَ لَهُ الرِّيَاحَ وَالْجِنَّ وَالشَّيَاطِينَ وَالْإِنْسِ وَآتَيْتَ وأحييت لعيسى الموتى فماذا جعلت لي He says, Oh my Allah, you suffered left for Dawood alayhi salam. You spoke directly to Musa alayhi salam. You gave Sulaiman alayhi salam a kingdom. No one will ever receive a kingdom like that. You subjugated the jinnat and the shayateen for him. Oh Allah, you brought the dead to life for Isa alayhi salam. What have you kept for me? فماذا جعلت لي What have you kept for me? Allah responds to him, أَوَلَيْسَ قَدْ آتَيْتُكَ أَفْضَلَ مِنْ ذَلِكَ كُلِّهِ Have I not given you better than all this? Have I not given you better than all this? Adam Safiullah alayhi salam, Musa Kalimullah alayhi salam, Ibrahim Khalilullah alayhi salam, Isa Ruhullah alayhi salam, Amma Anta, Fahabibullah. You are the beloved of Allah. You are the beloved of Allah. Wa Allah Dukir, Illa Dukir Tamai. And from now till Qiyamah, my name will not be taken except that your name will be taken with my name. La ilaha illallah, Muhammadur Rasulullah. Yunada bihi, fi jawis sama. The muazzin shouts out, 5 times every day, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. And immediately with that, Ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah. Abdullah bin Abbas radiallahu anhu makes tafsir of Allah dukir, illa dukir tama'i, fil adhan, wal iqama, wal tashahud, wa yawm al jumu'ati, ala al manabir, wa yawm al fitr, wa yawm al adha, wa inna al jimar, wa bayna al safa wal marwa, wa fi khutbat al nikah, wa fi masharik al ard, wa magharibiha. The name of Allah, with the name of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, never to be separated, not in azan, not in iqamah, not in tashahud in salah, not on the day of Jumu'ah, on the members of the entire world, not in the khutbah of nikah, not by Arafah, not Mina, not Safa, not Marwa, not in the east, not in the west, will the name of Allah ever be separated from the name of Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Such a Nabi this ummah was given, yet everything, placed on the mantle of Qurbani and sacrifice for this ummah. So that he stands on Mount Safa, calls out to Jibreel, Ya Jibreel, Walladhi nafsu Muhammadin biyadihi, ma amsa li ali Muhammad, suffatun min daqiq, wala kaffatun min sha'ir. He says, O Jibreel, by the qasam of that being in whose hands lies the life of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, today the home of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, there isn't one grain of wheat or one strand of barley. There is nothing. Married to the richest woman in Makkah, Sayyidina Khadija radiallahu ta'ala anha. Her caravan used to go to foreign countries for trade and commerce. Yet the day comes. The home is empty. Bukhari Sharif riwayat. Jibreel comes to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Oh my beloved Nabi, Khadija has prepared some food for you. She is on her way to you. Allah has sent me, Jibreel, to convey his salam to Khadija. Allah has sent me to convey his salam to Khadija. She has suffered greatly As a result of your deen, Allah has sent me with this basharat and glad tidings. Tell her that her home is already prepared in Jannah. La sakhaba fihi wa la ta'ab. There will be no pain, no discomfort, no hardship. The bunyan of marriage, the first marriage of Islam, the first home of nubuwwah. Ya Khadija, in Qata'a, ayyamun nawmi wa raha. He comes to her, O Khadija, the days of sleep and rest for Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam have come to an end. 360 idols in Ka'batullah. Allah says, tell them, one Allah is being. Man adu, man yastajib. Who am I going to invite? Who is going to listen? What is her response? Anta awwalu man tadu, ana awwalu man astajib. You be the first to give the da'wat, I will be the first to say labbay. And everything she gave, everything. Today in the name of Islam, in the name of Sunnah, in the name of Deen, we are filling the home. We are filling the home with the things of dunya. Khadija emptied her home, everything was given. Nowadays even halka wari taleem takes place. What do the masturat come back with? We saw that lounge suite, or we saw that curtain, or we saw that latest outfit, or we saw this. Such an environment of dunya. Which direction is this ummah going in? Allah's Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam goes to his daughter, knocks at the door. With a weak voice, she asks, who is it? He says, it is your father. Wa ma'i Imran bin Hussein, and with me is Imran bin Hussein. He says, my father, I cannot open the door for you. I cannot allow you to enter. Why? Because with you is Imran. With you is Imran, a stranger, a ghair mahram. And I don't have sufficient chadar or cloak to cover myself. Hazrat Maulana Yusuf Sahib Rahmatullah Ali used to say, the home of Nubuwwat, the home of Nubuwwat, there wasn't chadar or cloak to cover Hazrat. And the home of today, every season a new outfit. Every season change of furniture. Lavish wedding ceremony. Millions extravagantly spent. When the ummah is in such a situation, in such a plight, that they are little babies crying on the breast of their mothers. Those breasts are dry with those wet tears. The tears dry and those children go to sleep hungry. In an age and era when this ummah is facing such a situation, where is the allowance? Where is the justification for the type of wedding they're thinking? Where is the justification for the flamboyant extravagance and display of wealth? Youngster, he's depressed by what happened. What happened? My soccer team lost, or my cricket team lost. Insan is dying without iman on our doorstep. Those born with iman are becoming murtad. The homes of this ummah are empty. Our brothers and sisters are going hungry. And what is the dard in the heart? What is the pain in the heart? What is the concern in the heart? Sayyidina Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, when there was drought, he took qasam and oath that not one piece of meat will enter the mouth of Umar as long as there is meat in every home in Medina. He said, if a dog has to die hungry, if a dog has to die hungry on the banks of the river Dajjalah, Allah is going to question Umar. Where is that consciousness? Where is that munasabat? Where is that fikr and concern for humanity? He knocks at the door. Fatima, it is your father, with me is Imran. She says, I don't have chadar or cloak to cover myself. What does Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam do? He takes up his own chadar. He takes up his own cloak, passes it into the house. Fatima covers herself. When he enters, he embraces her. She bursts into tears. Amrad, asqam, oja. Amrad, asqam, oja. Sickness, hunger, pain, difficulty has overtaken. One narration, it comes, there isn't even food to feed the grandchildren, Hassan and Hussein radiallahu ta'ala. The apple of the eye of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Rehanatayya, Sayyida Shababi Ahlil Jannah, the home of Nubuwwat emptied. For what? For the sake of the hidayat of the Sunnah. No stone was left unturned. He places his Mubarak chin on the crown of the head of Fatima. Hawini alayk, hawini alayk.
هوني عليك فاطمة, do not make this difficult. والذي بعث أباك بالحق ما ذقت منذ ثلاثة أيام الزواقة. By the قسم of that being who sent your father with the truth, I also have not eaten for 3 days. I also have not eaten for 3 days. وكفى بك شرفا أن تكوني سيدة نساء أهل الجنة. Fatima, is it not sufficient? Is it not sufficient? You will undergo this qurbani. You will undergo this hardship. You will undergo this starvation, this difficulty in this world. In exchange for it, Allah has made you the queen of the women of Jannah. ألا إن سلعة الله غالية ألا إن سلعة الله الجنة. Listen, the price of Allah is expensive. The price of Allah is Jannah. He stands on Mount Safa. By the qasam of Allah, the home of Nubuwwat is emptied. إِذْ سَمِعَ فِي السَّمَاءِ وَجْبَى. All of a sudden, a thunderous explosion is heard. Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم becomes alarmed. أَمَرَ اللَّهُ السَّاعَةَ أَن تَقُومَ. Jibreel, has Allah ordered Qiyamah to come? Has Allah ordered Qiyamah to come? He says, no, no, no. Your call has reached the Arsh of Allah. Allah has dispatched an angel, Israfil alayhi salam, who has never come before to the earth. Israfil presents himself before Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Inna rabbaka sami'a kalamak. Inna rabbaka sami'a kalamak. Wa ba'athani ilayk bimafatihi khazain al-ard. أن أعرض عليك أن أسير معك جبال تهام الذهب وفضة وزمرد وياقوت. Allah has heard your call. Allah has heard your call and Allah has sent me with the key to the treasures of the earth. To present to you that if you want, this entire Tihama range of mountains will be turned into gold, into silver, into rubies, into emeralds. عبد النبي أو ملك النبي عبد النبي أو ملك النبي. Do you want to be a slave and a Nabi or do you want to be a king and a Nabi? My respected brothers, by the qasam of my Allah, by the qasam of my Allah, if he chose to be a king, if he chose to be a king, if he chose ease, if he chose comfort, this would not have diminished his maqam and his status even by one iota. Yet, voluntarily, اختياري طور پر, voluntarily, he said, بَلْ عَبْدَ النَّبِيَّ بَلْ عَبْدَ النَّبِيَّ. I want to be a slave and a Nabi. عَرَضَ عَلَيَّ رَبِّي أَنْ يَجْعَلَ بَطْحَاءَ مَكَّةَ ذَهَبًا وَفِضَّةً فَأَبَيْتُ وَقُلْتُ يَا رَبِّي أَجُوعُ يَوْمًا وَأَشْبَعُ يَوْمًا إِذَا جُعْتُ تَضَرَّعْتُ إِلَيْكَ وَسَأَلْتُكَ وَإِذَا شَبِعْتُ حَمِدْتُكَ وَشَكَرْتُكَ. He said, my Rabb offered me to turn the mountain ranges of Makkah into gold for me. I said, no, my Allah, I will go hungry one day, I will eat one day. When I go hungry, I will beg from you and ask from you. When I eat, I will make your shukr and I will praise you. He knew what majority of his ummah will be going through. He knew that majority of his ummah will be in faqa. He kept himself in such level of poverty. On this we will terminate, my respected brothers. Allah's Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it was his practice when he would go in the path of Allah. The last person he would meet was Fatima, turakat sara, and he would go in the path of Allah. When he would return, turakat sara, and the first person he would meet is Fatima radiallahu anha. Such was the bond of affection between father and daughter. When he returns from one journey, he comes to Fatima radiallahu anha. When she looks at him, she bursts into tears. Ya Fatima, ma yubkik. He says, oh Fatima, what is causing you to cry? She says, araka ya Rasulallah, qad shahuba lawnuk wa khlawlaqat thiyabuk. She says, I can see my father. Your clothes are tattered and torn. Your body has become emaciated. Such was the extent he suffered for the sake of this ummah, that the signs were there on his body. He says, I can't bear to see you in this condition. This is why I'm crying. He says, Ya Fatima, la tabki. Fatima, do not cry. Why? فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ بَعَثَ أَبَاكِ بِأَمْرٍ لَا يَبْقَى عَلَى ظَهْرِ الْأَرْضِ بَيْتُ مَدَرٍ وَلَا وَبَنٍ وَلَا شَارٍ إِلَّا أَدْخَلَهُ اللَّهُ فِيهِ عِزًّا أَوْ ذُلًّا حتى يبلغ هذا الأمر من حيث يبلغ الليل والنهار. أو كما قال صلى الله عليه وسلم. What is the crux? What is the crux of what he said? Fatima is saying, I cannot see you suffering like this. What does he say? He says, Fatima, this suffering is not in vain. This hunger is not in vain. This is the seed. This is the fertilizer. This is the water that will water the garden of Hidayat for my people. Allah will bring that day. The noor of Hidayat will enter every home on the surface of this earth. But Qurbani has to be given. Sacrifice has to be given. Wallah, my respected brothers, that day is coming. The question is, who will be used for that? Who will bring alive the legacy of rahmat and mercy of Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam? This dard, this pain, this cry, this concern, this worry for humanity that was the day and night of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. My respected brothers, don't look left, don't look right. Don't look at our watch. Don't look at our financial circumstance. The clock of our life is ticking. Akhirat is coming. The day we have to stand in Allah's court is coming. The day we want to receive Jame Kosar from the hand of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Sahaba will be coming on that day with their qurbani and sacrifice. They will be saying, Fika wa fi Rasulik, for your sake, for Allah's sake, and the sake of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. My respected brothers, we also have to prepare something for that day. We also have to prepare something for that day. Don't look left, don't look right. The standing up that we are being asked to do, this is not some document we are signing. Nor is it a promise. The standing up is dua. We are begging and we are asking Allah, Ya Allah, you accept me to strive for the deen of Rasulullah. Ya Allah, you accept me for the worry of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam for humanity. Ya Allah, my Nabi was a rahmat for the alam. Ya Allah, you use me to keep alive his legacy of rahmat and mercy for humanity. For this, our elders are saying, to learn this responsibility, if we haven't been for 4 months in the path of Allah, now is the time, make niyat. Who's ready, inshallah, to make niyat? Four months to go in the path of Allah, stand up, mashallah. Very, very quickly, those that haven't been, we want those brothers to stand up now, to make niyat, inshallah, to go 4 months in the path of Allah. Stand up, don't wait for others to stand. Our standing will encourage others to stand, inshallah. Jaldi jaldi karo bhai. 4 mahine, kaun taiyar hai bhai? Jisne abhi tak... जो अभी तक नहीं गए ये पहली मर्तबा अभी दिल से ये अहद कर लो दुआ कर लो अल्लाह से कि अल्लाह मुझे कबूल फरमाए 4 महीने के लिए चला माशाल्लाह दोज हैवंट बीन 4 मंथ्स माशाल्लाह चला बे मेक नियर भाई الحمد كما أنت أهل وصل وسلم على سيدنا محمد كما أنت أهل وفعل بنا ما أنت أهل بينك أهل التقوى وأهل المغفرة اللهم إنا على ذكرك وشكرك وحسن عبادتك ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار اللهم إنا ندعوك الله وندعوك الرحمن وندعوك البر الرحيم وندعوك بأسمائك الحسنى كلها ما علمنا منه وما لم نعلم أن تغفر لنا وترحمنا لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إنا كنا من الظالمين ربنا ظلمنا وإن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكونن من الخاسرين اللهم إن مغفرتك أوسع من ذنوبنا ورحمتك أرجع عندنا من أعمالنا يا غفار الذنوب يا ستار العيوب اغفر لنا ولجميع أمة محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم اللهم ارحم أمة محمد اللهم تجاوز عن سيئات أمة محمد اللهم أصلح أمة محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم اللهم اهدي أمة محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم اللهم اهدي الإنس والجان اللهم افتح أبواب الهداية اللهم أخرج الناس من الظلمات إلى النور وجنبهم الفواحش ما ظهر منها وما بطن يا رب العالمين اللهم اجعلنا هداة مهتدين غير ضالين ولا مضلين يا رب العالمين اللهم اجعل نبينا لنا فرطا وحوضه لنا موردا اللهم احشرنا في زمرة محمد واستعمل على سنته واجعلنا من حزبه يا رب العالمين اللهم اجعل اجتماعنا هذا اجتماعا مرحوما واجعل تفرقنا من بعده تفرقا معصوما ولا تجعل فينا ولا منا ولا معنا شقيا ولا محروما برحمتك ومنك وفضلك وكرمك يا اكرم الاكرمين وصلى الله تعالى على خير خلقه سيدنا ومطاعنا محمد وعلى اله وصحبه اجمعين